You live in the USA, made some income from wood turning, wondering what are the tax implications? Let's talk about it today. Hi, I'm Mike Peace, and I'm here to share my passion about wood turning, but today we're really going to talk about taxes in wood turning. Who's my target audience for this video? It's the individual who's primarily a hobby turner, someone who makes a little money on the side incidentally or to supplement their regular job or retirement, but they're not making their living from wood turning. This video may be for you. I doubt there's much of any relevance or usefulness to it for someone living outside the USA whose tax laws I know nothing about. This video is not targeted for someone who makes a livelihood from wood turning and probably should be consulting with a tax professional because of more complex issues like depreciation or business use of their home, liability insurance, retirement plans, medical coverage, cost accounting, issues dealing with inventory cost, overhead cost, employee expenses, you know the drill. If you fall in this category, you need to see a certified public accountant or a tax professional. Now, why should any of this be important to you? Well, as Jesus said, render unto Caesar. As a citizen, it behooves you to obey the law and pay your tax obligations. It's the right thing to do, and it is the law. Failure to do so can get you in hot water with IRS and can include audits, fines, and penalties. Caveat emptor. I'm going to be talking in generalities, and my advice should not be considered professional tax or legal advice, and you're solely responsible for your own tax situation. My main purpose is just to give you a little better understanding of tax consequences of some of your income from your hobby. Example one, you quit wood turning and you sell your lathe and all your equipment and you get less money for it than you paid for it. There is no taxable income, so you can disregard that. Example number two, you had a neighbor come over and visit your shop and she was so impressed with your work, she insisted on buying a bowl and she gave you $30. Okay, that is taxable income. IRS says that you must include on your return from an activity from which you don't expect to make a profit. An example of this type of activity is a hobby or farm that you operate mostly for recreation and pleasure. Okay, so you're going to enter this information on line 21 of your 1040 under other income, and you're not going to deal with any business expenses. Now, let's go to a little more complex example. Let's say example number three. Maybe you're doing a lot better than selling a bowl once a year. Let's say you've sold work totaling $500 and you demonstrated a club for a couple hundred bucks for a total of $700. The easiest thing to do is put this on line 21 and declare it all as income, as we've said earlier, and you won't have to pay FICA or Medicare, that self-employment tax that we're going to talk about in a moment. But you won't get to deduct any business expenses either. Now, example four, you're retired and you're a serious turner. You're beginning to make a few bucks at which that might help cover your hobby expenses. You may do an occasional workshop at a club for pay or a local wood turning store. You may have demonstrated for a club and gotten paid for your effort. You may have some of your work in a gallery and they're beginning to sell your work and you're making a little bit of money. Perhaps you wrote an article for a magazine and got paid. Or you demonstrated at a national symposium like I did, and to your surprise, they report that income to IRS and you get a 1099 miscellaneous form, non-employee income. Now you have tax consequences that you clearly have to deal with. So it's time to start keeping good records and start dealing with those business expenses. Now, what are legitimate business expenses? Well, IRS says it's ordinary and necessary. In Pub 17, they say you may be able to deduct ordinary and necessary business-related expenses you have for travel, entertainment, gifts, or transportation. An ordinary expense is one that is common and accepted in your trade or business. A necessary expense is one that is helpful and appropriate for your business. An expense doesn't have to be required to be necessary. So here's an example. That 200-mile round trip you did for that club demonstration is a 53.5 cents per mile legitimate business expense, and that reduces your income by more than $100. It also lowers your income tax and your self-employment tax. Booth fees that you paid for at a craft show, legitimate business expense. You can get more information on business expenses in IRS publication 53035. So how do you deal with these expenses? Well, you're going to deal with it by completing what's called a Schedule C on your tax return. If you are using a tax software program, if you're doing your taxes yourself, you want to use a tax software program, make sure you get a version that will cover self-employment and Schedule C. And one last tip. This self-employment income you make that is determined by the Schedule C, you can put it in a Roth IRA and it'll grow tax-free. I hope this has been useful for you. I apologize for the video quality. I'm struggling with some new webcam microphone setup, but it'll get better with a little bit of practice. Y'all come on back here.